Yeah, I got a motherfucking family to feed. Was a juvenile, just like 100 degree. We was serving and scamming, ain't got no degree. We ain't got no diplomas, but we got some peas. All the hand is sitting, that shit a disease. I'm a rapper tonight.
Alright, what is up, guys? It's your boy Robbie from Good Game Bullies. Y'all can find me on Instagram, but today's video topic is everything you're gonna need to whelp puppies. Alright, so we're gonna be moving from left to right here. If you could just show what we got really quick, a quick little sneak peek. I've been whelping for a few days, you know, I've been learning, I've done my research, but we'll give you a quick sneak peek. We had an XB granddaughter and a Shocker son, if you knew Shocker from MM Bullies. They got some real good dogs, but Zara is a tricolor. It carries cream, so I didn't know she carried cream until they were born, but we got lucky with cream. Dad is cream, he's really structured, really well built. But you know, 7 puppies right here. But yeah, we'll show you guys a little more of that towards the end of the video. But let's get started. So one of the first things you're gonna need are syringes. You can get them in different sizes. These are, I believe, 20 milliliter syringes. These could just be used for feeding, for any general things. Also, a lot of 1 millimeter syringes. We're gonna need these for administering, you know, enemas, administering medications, feeding, tube feeding. A lot of the. I accidentally bought an extra pack, but it actually came in clutch. So 1 millimeter syringes, 3 millimeter ones also work as well. Another thing you're gonna need for whelping, or even before you get your dog pregnant, you're gonna need some folic acid. This one is Vitamatic. It's 5 milligrams. You can find this on Amazon. It's pretty inexpensive, and this is just to prevent cleft palate and all those issues with smash face dogs. And let's see, another thing for mama you're gonna need this. It's not Oxymama, it's for after. You're gonna need this Oxymate. This thing is really good for, you know, just general vitamins to for the babies to start developing in the mama's womb. So we got those. Another thing that goes along with the syringes, we got these tube feedings. So these tube feeding kits are really important. Thankfully, I did not have to use any tube feeding kits, but yeah, you just basically measure their jaw to the rib line, make a little marking on this thing, and then administer it very slowly. I may do a video on that, I may not. I didn't really need a tube feed them since they're fully developed once they got out. But there's that. Another thing you're gonna need. I got this one. This one's foster care by Breeder's Edge. It's provides complete nutrition with digestive and immunitive support. So this one's pretty cool. I haven't used too much formula because mom's been producing milk. I've only used this, you know, a couple times, but it's been useful when I did need it to relieve mama. I also mixed this along with some of these goat milks. So this could go along with this. I mix them up. You can make whatever mix you want. These are really important. Another thing is this. It's called a fading puppy support. So this basically helps dogs that are fading or that are a little weak. You notice they won't latch on. I actually administer this to a couple of my dogs when I first had my litter because I noticed they were not latching. But as soon as I gave them that, in the next hour or less, they started latching, and ever since, they've been really good. It's been really nice. So let's see here. Another thing you're gonna need, some Tums. This is just to help mom get calcium in her system. It's antacid. You know, mamas usually don't really want to eat right away, so it'll just help her out a little bit. Yeah, another thing I should mention right now that goes along with the formula, you're gonna want Pedialyte unflavored. I've seen people do other flavors, but here we go. Pedialyte, just generic Pedialyte. This is really useful. You either mix this or distilled water. Sometimes Pedialyte could dehydrate your dogs, but I get distilled water, or you could do water bottles as well. But that'll work, you feel me? And then another thing. We got this Oral Cow Plus. This thing I've been using, it's been working really well. It's by Breeder's Edge. I mean, you can use any brand, but this one's vanilla flavor, so My bitch actually really likes it, so it's really nice. This has worked very well for me. I'd really recommend this for any calcium supplement. Another thing along with that, while we're talking about getting mom to lactate, another thing that I have that you should have on hand is goat cheese or cottage cheese, to help mom start lactating, as well as vanilla yogurt and ice cream. She at first few days she wasn't really eating, but she was eating the goat cheese and the ice cream and everything, so that really kept her up and lactating. So next thing, nurture mate. This is colostrum. You're gonna need colostrum for puppies because it helps with their immunity when they're born. I give it to them because I was helping out with the C-section. I give it to them right when they're born. I just, you know, gotta put a little bit on the glove on my finger and administer it through them orally. Personally, I don't put it in their mouth and squeeze it because you don't know how much, you don't want them to aspirate. You don't want them to get too much in their system. So there's that. Another thing, you're gonna need dewormers. Right here, you could. So this one is pyranthol. I got the Nemex too because it's safer for, you know, younger puppies, and Safeguard, obviously a lot of people use that, so a little Safeguard. Nemex 2, these are for deworming. You know you're gonna want to deworm your dogs at, I believe it's people do it differently, but there's different schedules, but you could do like 2, 4, 6, 8, like, well, I'm gonna make a video when I'm deworming my puppies, so we'll get to that. If you guys are interested in that, stay caught up on my channel and we'll get that posted up. Another thing is very important, very, very important, a scale. This one isn't a specific puppy scale, but it works very well because removable lid, you're able to clean the lid, put it back on, or you could measure them on a bowl. But you want to make sure your puppies are consistently gaining weight. And if they're not, then you're going to have to tube feed, or you're going to have to bottle feed. You have to figure something out because they're supposed to be gaining 5 to 10% of their weight every single day. So you're gonna want to be weighing them every morning, every night, at least every day though. So scale, very important. Another thing, we got these puppy bowls. I haven't had to use them. This is just for when the dogs are weaning. Weaning is just when they're transitioning from mama to solid food. So thankfully, you know, mama's a good mama. She's been really easy on me, so I haven't had to tube feed. Another thing, we're gonna need some Vaseline. So this Vaseline, it's either gonna be used for a few things. So first thing, you're gonna need it for taking mama's temperature. You know, you put a little bit on this thermometer, and you're gonna want to administer this through the anus. So you're gonna want to go all the way in there. At first my dog was a little uncomfortable with it, she got used to it, but yeah, you're just gonna be watching out for her temperature. When she gets near to delivering her puppies, you'll notice her temperature will drop. So let's say a day before she went into labor, her temperature had dropped to 98.5. So I knew she was like already almost ready. Kept fluctuating there, but very important. Check your bitch's temperature when she's about to be ready. You know, you want to check that the last week, every single week. Another thing, pet pessitin. So this pet pessitin is basically if your dogs are having diarrhea, they have watery stool, you know, you want them to have solid stool. So this helps out. You put like a little bit amount, it tells you on the bottle, but pet pessitin, diarrhea medication, really nice, something you're going to need. First aid antiseptic. You'll also need this for the baby's umbilical cords, the mama's womb, if it's not healing correctly. Luckily, I didn't have to use it, but I did have it on deck just in case stuff wasn't healing up like I want to. Along with that, we got that Neosporin. You know, this is the same thing. You know, if you need a, when you're doing enemas, you know, you need to use a little bit of this, or if you're putting some on mom's wound. I just used it today, but her wound has been healing very nice, thankfully. All right, and then another thing you're gonna need is a blender. This one, I don't have my full blender with me, but basically you put the little bottle on, and then you put the thing on, and then it's just really convenient that it's a to-go one. It's to mix the formula I was talking about earlier. So we're done with this as well. All right, another thing you're gonna want is a digital thermometer and a physical thermometer. So this one, just I use this just to check the puppy's temperature when they're in the whelping box to make sure everything's good. So this was a really good buy. You know, I check their temperatures from afar, see if everyone's doing good. Another thing we got here We got some nail clippers, a nail grinder. Around when they're a few weeks, you're gonna want to get them accustomed to, you know, hearing the air grinder. I mean, hearing this grinder. So when they're later, so when they get older later, you will have less problems. Because with my current female, a mistake that I made was not getting her used to this. And nails have been really hard. So you want to start them off early, start clipping their nails early. Once they get a few weeks, two, three weeks, once you start deworming them, you could, you know, start clipping their nails again. Another thing that you might need that I would really recommend are these identification bands. Let's say if you want to name your puppies or you want to keep track of them. For me, I didn't think I was going to need them, but once I had my litter, I had five creams, three cream boys, two cream girls, and I needed to associate them. So this came in really clutch. And these also came with a weight chart. I'd also recommend either printing out a weight chart or using the one that comes with, or even this breeder's. I didn't really end up using this, but it was a breeder's companion book. Lots of useful information inside of here. If you guys really don't know, there's lots of pages that are informational. It also comes with your puppy weight chart. Lots of information. Fill in information as well. Didn't really need that. I think I'm going to return that on Amazon. But it did have useful information. I did read that. Another thing. I only have one pack left, but wet wipes. I am only on day 6 of whelping. About to be 7, so they're about to be a week old. But I already used, I think, 7 or 8 packs of this. So this is going to be, you're going to need wet wipes. I get water wipes just because they don't have anything in them. You know, 99% water. Purest baby wipes, but there's also some other brands that work, you know, like just generic brands. They work very well. Those work well as well. These you're going to use for either mom to clean her up when she's bleeding, because she still will drain after she's done giving birth. And also, these are used to, for the pee-pee and potty time, you have to stimulate potties. Every time after they eat, they always have to at least pee. And then bottle. This is, of course, used for the formula. I have a little formula right here I used earlier. I hadn't really used it because mama was a good mama producing milk. But a little formula I got here. Ooh, and then one of my favorite things is this this electric aspirator. This has been a lifesaver. I mean, I have regular aspirators. These will work, you know, generic ones. But sometimes I notice I'll misplace them. And I even lost one, so good thing I had a couple replacements. But, you know, you want to at least have these physical ones. But electric ones works really nice. Multiple settings. Goes all the way to 3. Distraction light. Really amazing. I would really recommend this. And if not, I mean, the OG way works too. These are really cool. Another thing. You're going to want some gloves for when you're handling your puppies. Because, I mean, you don't want bacteria getting on them. You know, just keep it sanitary. Also, for the baby's mush, dyeing. This is going to be extra calories. You can start putting them on this as early as 4 weeks. Really nice. This puppies love this thing. It's like syrup. It's like really sweet. Personally, my bitch doesn't like it. She would not really eat it, but puppies love this, and lots of dogs love this, so this will work. Another thing you're going to need, some trash bags. Little trash bags. There's going to be lots of trash, lots of mess, because, I mean, it gets dirty. Lots of pee, lots of poop. Also, with the mess part, you're going to want these training pads. These training pads are really, really useful. So you just put these little babies inside of, you know, their whelping area and everything. That's cool. Let's see what else I got here. Another thing, this is optional, but this is an air purifier. I have lots of lint in my room, or had before I clean. So this just purifies the air. It also works as a fan for mom, because one thing I noticed was my girl was overheating, and she just, this really helped with her breathing. Because, you know, she had that labored breathing. So this helped. I just set this up on her. Make sure that the wind's not hitting the puppies or anything. Yeah. Also, another thing you can probably use is this. If you're going to build your own whelping box. Measuring stuff out. Cutting stuff. I had a little razor blade. But now we're going to move on to this playpen right here. It's another thing that I use. So if you could show inside the playpen. So inside the playpen, how I usually set it up. I usually have my heating pad. I put a little heating pad right here. Keep it at 85 to 90 the first week. But you see right here? See how I have all these? It's rigid. This prevents them from getting from getting swimmer syndrome. It also prevents them from getting flat chest. Those are really things you want to avoid while having your puppies develop. So yeah, I just have that under, put a heat pad in there, put this over, you know, cover it up like that. But yeah, it's really important for the development. If you get swimmer puppies, it's when their back legs don't work. I mean, you don't want that. You want your puppy to be healthy. You want them to fully develop. So very important. And flat chest, that's just basically like a death sentence for puppies because they can't eat correctly and they'll aspirate more and just something you don't want. You want them something they're able to climb and hop around in. Another thing you're going to need is lots of towels. Lots and lots of towels. See right here. Got blankets, some comfortable blankets, and some towels for putting around mom when we set her up to eat. And then, yeah, just keep it clean. You want to have some clean towels at all times. Also, this really awesome cleaning solution. You guys are going to need one. You only do like 2 teaspoons per little bottle. But this is chlorhexidine solution. So, really nice when it's diluted. It's really good cleaning solution. It also helps with skin conditions with mom. It's just, I've heard really good things about it. Good things have happened. And while I've used that, you know, good cleanings and everything. Another thing that's important is an incubator. This is a homemade one. You know, I'll just put my heating pad in here just to give mama some relief. Or, you know, the first few days you want to keep them in an incubator. It's just easy to move them around in this. It's a homemade one. Same thing. Look, guys. Under here, padding. You're gonna want to keep padding at all times as soon as they're born. What I did, as soon as they're born, I had one of these carpets in here because this also worked good for developing their back legs, making sure they don't get flat chests. But the thing is, they're expensive. You don't have to invest in this, but it's something that really helps. So incubator. Also, I don't have one, but people get oxygen machines. I heard that can be very important. Thankfully, I haven't been in need of the oxygen machine, but yeah. Also, of course, can't whelp without a whelping setup. So this is my little whelping setup right here. Don't worry, my socks are clean. This is a 48x48 whelping box. I love this thing. You know, the first few days I was sleeping in here with all the puppies. It's a really nice one, and I don't want to disturb the puppies too much, but also did a custom made guardrail. The one that it comes with, it's pretty all right. Basically, I did 1.5 inch, and I got these one and a half inches, and then this one is 1/2 inch. Then you put these, cut them up, line them up. There you go. This is just for the so the mama will not crush the babies. And then I have 2 of these. See, digital thermometers, you're gonna want these. So how I usually set it up, you know, leave one outside of the whelping box, see the temperature inside the room. You're going to want the temperature to be at least at 75. And then this one's at 86. You want it to be anywhere between 85 to 90 the first week. But yeah, I mean, that's basically, I know I forgot a few stuff. If I forgot stuff, please let me know down in the comments below. I mean, I'm learning along with you guys. It's been a really awesome journey so far. But yeah, we're going to show you guys a few puppies. Let me get my gloves really quick. Gotta stay sanitary. But yeah, basically. All right. So another thing that we forgot, my phone died earlier, so right before I was going to show you the puppies. But Oxy Mama is really important for her recuperation after she has those puppies. Multivitamins, herbs, essential amino acids. Really nice. Another thing I forgot to mention is a heating pad. So I got a pretty nice heating pad. Most of them do not have this stay-on function. But this one's a really nice one. It's brand pure. Has a 2-hour function and stays on. So it's really useful. Another thing, these red lights right here. I don't have them plugged in, but when they were first born, since I didn't have a heat lamp, I just used, you know, some red light. You know, I had that on them. It's really helps regenerate cells. Really cool. But yeah, so we're gonna get into showing you guys these puppies now. I'm gonna put this to the side. I don't really need this right now. But yeah, if you guys are interested, you guys can follow me on Instagram at goodgamebullies with an S. All right, let's just get into it. So first we got this male. It's a green male right here. He barely started getting some pigment. He looks like he might be a blue covered in cream. It's really nice. These pups are only 5-6 days old, I think. But man, they're looking thick. Even my C-section guy let me know. He's like, wow, these are thick puppies right when they got out. Another boy right here. It's the black collar boy. Same thing, his mask looks a little darker than some of the other ones. Really cute boy. They've been gaining nicely. 15 ounces now, started off at 9. 5th, 6th day, they've been gaining very nicely. Little buddy's hungry, it's almost feeding time. Another boy, biggest boy of the litter. He's about a pound now. A pound already, guys, look at him. He is big, his head is the biggest. He is gonna be a big boy. I think he's gonna look the most like Tommy. Very nice boy. Cream, you know, one of the lighter ones, one of the ones with the pink on them. All right, fourth boy, final boy that we got right now. We got this beautiful brindle with cream, you know, got that, he's hungry too, it's about feeding time, but he got that, you know, that nice color snout, nice marking on his face, cream on his chest. Smallest boy of the litter, really small and compact, really handsome boy right here. I almost wanted to keep them, but you know, you can't keep them all. Really beautiful boy. So now let's get into my girls. I ended up getting a pied female. I was not expecting this because Zara doesn't carry pie or brindle. So we got pied and brindle. So it's really cool. Added some structure. You know, you guys know pied and brindle add structures to your dogs. This was the smallest and lightest female on birth. Really beautiful female pied. We got that split face, nice markings. Okay, two other females I got right here. The biggest female right here, big girl. She weighs a pound as well. Yeah, well, the other ones are almost getting there, but it's a big girl right here. She got the biggest head too. You know, she's about to go, these pups are about to go crazy. It's one of the lightest ones. She got that lighter face. Not really too many blue markings. I'm gonna get these pups tested when I get the chance because they're all cream. They carry lots of, you know, colors. I'll get into the colors right now if you guys want to know. But also, let's wake this little girl up. Make sure she's good. Yeah, also, this little girl right here. Another little girl. She is the lightest. She's the lightest one of the litter. Not really many blue markings, but she's a really nice size. She was like the medium-sized girl. One thing I've noticed, pups are really muscular. Starting to gain really nicely. I'm going to add some pictures of the mom and dad, and you guys could also look at my Instagram, but you could find me on Instagram, TikTok, Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, just about every platform. I'm gonna start posting more, but if you guys are interested in any of these pups, please send me a private message on one of those. You could also text me at, if you guys are serious, text me at 714-588-8510. But yeah, Zara quad carrier tricolor. She's a black and tan, visual black and tan. And then she also carries cocoa. She carries blue. She carries cream. You know, black. Didn't carry pie or brindle, but she was very structured. She was a really nice female. XB granddaughter. Very beautiful. Now the dad, he's got that Grinch bloodline. You know, few times Dawn. You guys check on the Facebook. Few times Dawn. You know, Shocker's his dad. It's really, I seen him in person. He was really thick, really low to the ground. He really compliments. We'll see my girl. We'll see how they grow up. But he is a blue covered in cream. And, you know, from Big Block Bullies, if you guys don't know. But yeah, if you guys are interested, hit me up. Well, that's where we're going to conclude the video now. You know, got these cute little babies right here. Cute little babies. Look at this big boy right here. See? They're hungry. We're about to get into a feeding right now. Might do a video on feeding, on my technique. But yeah, that's about it, guys. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Good Game Bullies on Instagram. G-G-G-O-O-D-G-A-M-E. Bullies, B-U-L-L-Y-S. You can find me there. I'll leave it in the description. Have a great night. I hope everyone stays blessed.
I'm not ending it.
Bro, you gotta end the video.
Yeah, I got a motherfucking family to feed. Was a juvenile, just like 100 degree. We was serving and scamming, ain't got no degree. We ain't got no diplomas, but we got some peas. All the hate and the city, that shit a disease. I'm a rapper the next.